With the benefit of hindsight, it's easy to recognize the aura of toxicity that this person created. But as an inexperienced manager, I didn't always see it clearly. He does a lot of impressive work, I thought to myself. What I later realized is that the team actually becomes better off when brilliant souls leave. Yes, you lose out on their individual contributions, but the fog lifts for everyone else. They can let their guard down. Collaboration becomes more honest and productive, so the work of the team as a whole improves. The second thing I learned is that it is possible to find people who are just as talented and who are humble and kind. It's not an either or, as the movie would have you believe. You can and should hold the bar high for collaboration. These people are out there. Don't compromise your values for someone who thinks it is okay to bully others. You and your team deserves better. Hi, my name is Monica King, and you are at Books with Monica, where I read some of my favorite book and read yours. Today, I'm excited to introduce you to a book that I came across during COVID, The Making of a Manager by Julie Zoe. And I'm so excited I came across this because as somebody who now trains other managers and also have managers within my team, I now look back and realize, man, you know, thinking really from a manager mindset and just being a leader and an individual is very different. And let's take a moment, right? There's enough stats to prove that many people leave the workplace and love the workplace because of the relationship they have with their managers. And I agree as well. I think as an employee, when I worked at the government in nuclear nonproliferation or like at a nonprofit at the UN, like wherever it was, the relationship I had with my boss at that time, which will often be the managers, the supervisors, made a huge difference in how I felt about the role. Did they give me more opportunities? Did they permit me to try out different things? Did it feel safe to do so? And how did they make it easy to know that I can have ownership in what I do? I've had opposite examples as well, when they didn't have all of that and it felt very hard, very frustrating. And just even putting together a simple Excel sheet just felt emotionally draining. And for folks who's listening, you feel like, yeah, that's me. Like, it's a validation of being a good manager. Takes time. It's not born, we're made. And I think that's why this topic of making of the manager is so beautiful. And I think this particular piece that I read in her chapter about leading the small team, but regardless of size, I think often when we come across somebody very talented, especially in the hiring side, we look at their talent and say, geez, this person is so fantastic. We should absolutely have them. We take a moment to pause to see, forgetting that culture component. Is this person truly going to help amplify everyone's strength? Or is this person going to put a damper in how other people feel? That small nuance is really, really key. And as it speaks, I truly testament to it. I think at the early stages of Innovator's Box, I wanted to hire talent. I didn't worry too much about if somebody lacked on certain things or, you know, while we didn't have, as people describe here, we're kind of being jerks or assholes. I would say some people weren't as initially aligned and I didn't know that. But what I quickly learned over time, which is actually what I do and how I formed the wonderful teams we have right now, is kind of initially kind of overloading in our culture and expectation because I want to see how they're going to have ownership. And I want to also see how they respond to stress. And that's actually how I do a little bit of a kind of assessment. And what's their gut response? If I'm overloading them with information, the huge vision that we're building, what we're doing, do they get excited or do they get worried? Do they express concerns or are they looking forward to problem solving together? And that attitude gives me a little bit of hint of, is this person not only capable, but humble, kind, and an active problem solver? In fact, that's kind of the sentiment of how our entire team has formed at Innovator's Box and something that I now continue to advise in others to find that nuance. You don't have to give up positive values that are very important for you and key aspects of a personal aspect that is more than just the tactical skills. And so many more advice if you are a manager or bringing on managers, whatever that is, I highly recommend check out her book. While she does talk about, you know, having worked at Silicon Valley and, you know, her product experience, I truly believe that this insight is really invaluable. And so check it out. Thank you, Julie, for writing this on Making of the Manager. And again, we'll be back with another episode. This is Monica with Books with Monica. I'll see you later, folks.